Good morning. We warmly welcome all to our historic Cathedral Basilica as we celebrate the First Holy Communion. This weekend, we also want to remember the feast day of our patron saint, Saint Anthony of Padua, which is Saturday, June 13th, as we pray and seek his intercession for an end to this coronavirus pandemic and for peace in our world. God's word today calls us to a deeper appreciation and reverence for the real presence of our Lord in the Blessed Sacrament. Kindly deposit your contributions in the collection baskets, which will be in our aisles as you quietly exit at the end of today's Mass to receive the Eucharist. We greatly appreciate your generosity during this time. Please stand as we begin our First Holy Communion Mass.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Good morning, everyone. It's a wonderful day to come together and to celebrate the first communion of these beautiful children, because it's our feast day. It is June the 13th, the feast of Saint Anthony, and Saint Anthony is our special saint, who preached God's word from his heart, who took care of the poor, and finds things for us when they are lost. So as we begin, let's remember our baptism. When we first began our journey as Catholics. And let's renew our baptismal promises. Do you reject Satan and all his empty promises and all his devious deeds? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, descended into death, rose on the third day, ascended into heaven, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life of the world to come? This is our baptismal faith, the baptismal faith of all of our brothers and sisters who are Christian and Catholic throughout the world, and we are proud to profess it in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who gave Saint Anthony of Padua to your people as a wonderful preacher and who prayed constantly for the needs of the people, grant that with his prayers, as we follow the teachings of Christ's life, we may know your help in every time of trial and difficulty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Kindly be seated as we listen to God's holy word from Paul's letter to the Corinthians.
A reading from St. Paul's first letter to the church at Corinth. I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you, that on the night before he was to die on the cross, the Lord Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, Jesus took the chalice and said, "This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of my eternal covenant. Drink from it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink from this chalice, you proclaim the death of the Lord Jesus until he comes again in glory." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing copies of be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When the day to celebrate the Jewish feast of Passover arrived, Jesus and his apostles took their place at table. While they were eating, Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice. Again, he gave thanks and praise, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for many, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." When they had sung a hymn afterwards, they went out to pray on the Mount of Olives. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Kindly be seated. On the news this week, boys and girls, it was reported that someone found a treasure in the foothills of the West. And to find the treasure that was buried there, and it was a lot of gold, and it was a lot of fine jewelry. How many saw that on the news? Raise your hand. Not too many, huh? Okay. But if you were, what happened was the man that buried the treasure many, many years ago, he's still living. He's an old man. Okay. And you know what he made to help people find the treasure that was buried? What do you think that he made and that they had to follow? They had to follow. Anybody have an idea? Well, a map. That's what he made. He made a map. And some people weren't able to follow the map. It's kind of like a detective story. You have to know what to be looking for, to follow. And then somebody, and I don't know who the person's name was because they didn't give us the person's name that found the treasure this week, but they followed the map and they followed all the clues and they got to the treasure. And they're very happy because it was a big treasure. It was over $1 million. Today we listen as we come to First Holy Communion and we come to celebrate St. Anthony's feast day, We listen to God's treasure map. The scriptures are God telling us how to reach the treasure. And what's the treasure? The treasure is to be in union, to be a saint, and to live with God forever. That's the treasure. Why do I say that the scriptures are the treasure map? Well, today's first reading is the treasure map that we have from the year 54. That was 54 years from Jesus' birth. That was a long time ago, huh? That first reading was written by Paul, St. Paul. He wrote it in a place called Ephesus. It still exists, the place. And he wrote to people who were living in Corinth, big city. And he wrote to them about finding the treasure. He says, I am passing to you what I have received. I'm passing on. This is the treasure that you'll find. Because on the night before Jesus died, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to the apostles, the disciples, saying, this is my body. St. Paul also talks about the chalice, where Jesus, the night before he died, that's in the year 30, about 33. So that's 20 years before even Paul is writing the treasure map. He says, Jesus tasted the chalice and he again gives thanks. And he says, in this chalice is my blood. Now you drink it. And every time you do this, you eat my bread, eat my flesh, and drink my blood, I am with you. Today's gospel was written 30 years after that. It was written in the year about 80. And you know what? It has the same map. The same treasure map. It has the same words. And so as we come to receive our Holy Communion, we come to receive the greatest treasure of all, Jesus. To be in a holy communion, one with Jesus, one with God. And that is to help us to get to heaven, to be with God forever. And we can trace from here, June 13th, 2021, we can trace through all the documents and all of the writings of the Catholic Church and all the saints and all the books of Scripture of the New Testament, we can find that there is an unbroken line in that map to the treasure of Jesus in the Holy Eucharist. Jesus came to save us, and he comes to give us himself all the time, so that we can continue on our journey to heaven. He gives us nourishment, but he just doesn't give us ordinary bread or ordinary drink. He gives us his very self, his body, his blood, so that we continue on our journey to heaven. Here, as we listen to all of the writings of the church, all the writings of the saints, all the writings of the gospel writers, all the great fathers of the church, we come and we receive the treasure of the bread of angels, Jesus Christ. And so, later on in life, you're going to have to write papers. You're going to have to do some research. At the bottom of every single paper that you do in college, or you do in after college, in the university, graduate school, if you go for a doctorate degree, you have to be able to cite the proof for your conclusion in the paper. Those are called references. We have the most foolproof references there are to saying that from the beginning, when Jesus came to earth, this bread and wine that will be prayed over during this Mass, we have writings from 2021 all the way back to the time of Jesus that say, this is the true treasure, Jesus, his body, his blood, his soul, his divinity, all of Jesus. And he gives us this divine nourishment, this fine food to help us to get to heaven, to continue our journey to the promised land. So today, boys and girls, you receive a special treasure that will help you on your journey. You will receive Jesus. Jesus who gives you strength and gives you guidance on how to get to heaven. Let us stand and continue our prayer to the Lord.
We pray for our holy Catholic Church, that it may always feed us with God's word from the Bible, with the body and blood of Jesus in Holy Communion, and with the very long history of our Church's sacred traditions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our parents, sisters and brothers, relatives and friends, that they may always have a deep and growing love for God, say their daily prayers, go to confession often, and receive Holy Communion at Mass, especially on weekends and holy days. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our pastors, deacons, teachers, Mrs. Diane and Miss Debbie, and all who helped our beautiful children prepare for their first Holy Communion, that they may be blessed by God for their goodness and love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our children who today receive for the very first time our Lord Jesus Christ in Holy Communion, that they may be protected from all evil and live faithful as Catholics all the days of their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those of our families and friends who have died, that our loving Lord may grant them mercy, forgiveness, and a special place in heaven at the holy table of the Lamb of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of us gathered here, that each of us may be very grateful to our Lord for the divine gift of the body and blood of Jesus in Holy Communion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the special intentions which we hold in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we ask all these things in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Kindly be seated as we prepare to celebrate Mass at the altar. Pray, my sisters and my brothers in baptism, that the offering we bring to this holy altar might become the sacrifice which is acceptable to God, our Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings we place on your altar, in memory of Saint Anthony of Padua, so that as you brought him to the glories of heaven, you may, through this holy mass, grant us your pardon and bring us to heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
God, our loving Father, we are glad to give you thanks and praise because you love us. Because you love us, you have given us the great gift of life. Because you love us, you have given us this beautiful world. Because you love us, you have given us Jesus, your Son, in this Holy Communion to bring us to you and to gather us around him as the children of one family. For such great love, we thank you with all the angels and saints in their song of praise. Blessed be Jesus, whom you sent to be the friend of children, the sick, the suffering, and the poor. He came to show us how we can love you, Father, by loving one another. He came to take away sin, which keeps us from being friends, and hate, which makes us all unhappy. He promised to send the Holy Spirit to be with us always, so that we can live as your loving children. God our Father, we now ask you to send your Holy Spirit to change these gifts of bread and wine into the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. The night before he died, Jesus, your Son, showed us how much you love us. When he was at supper with his disciples, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. And so, loving Father, we remember that Jesus died and rose again to save the world. He put himself into our hands to be the sacrifice we offer you. Lord our God, listen to our prayer. Send the Holy Spirit to all of us who share in this meal. May this Spirit bring us closer together in the family of the Church, with Francis our Pope, Curtis our Bishop, David, who is named this week as our next bishop, all of our first communicants and their families, and all your people. Remember those who have died. Bring them home to be with you forever. Gather us all together in your kingdom. There we shall be happy forever with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, and our Mother, with her all-good and holy husband Joseph, the blessed apostles Peter and Paul, the martyrs, especially Lawrence Martyr, Deacon, Saint Anthony, our special saint, and all the saints. They're all the friends of Jesus the Lord will sing a song of joy. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and taught by divine teaching, we stand and dare to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always freed from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the power of the power glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer to each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of our world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you shall enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ. What do you
mean? Blood of Christ the Lord. At this table, the lust shall be first, for there is servir, for Genius is above.
The body of Christ. You're going to take your mask off now. No, no. In your hands like the day. The body of Christ.
Cuerpo del Señor. Cup of blessing. Blood of Christ the Lord. At this table, Allah shall be blessed.
You're going to take off your mask. The body of Christ, and you're holding your hands. And then we'll go to that side. Whatever side you're sitting on. Is she receiving communion? Take off your mask. Now put your hands out the right way. The body of Christ. Okay. And what side are you sitting on? That side or this side? Which side are you sitting on? This side. Just just go there. Eat the communion. And now go over there. And take down your mask, okay? And put out your hands just like you had them, the body of Christ. And now eat the host. Now eat it. Eat it. It's a big dress, isn't it, huh? Take down the mask, okay? And put your hands out like you're taught. The body of Christ. Amen. Now eat Jesus. The body of Christ. You've got to take down your mask first. Very good. You can take down your mask. The body of Christ. Eat Jesus right now. Okay. And you can take down your mask, the body of Christ. Put your hands out like you were taught.
Yeah, that's right.
Now eat Jesus. Okay. Oh, eat Jesus. That's good. That's good. Take down your mask, please, and put your hands together, the body of Christ. Amen. Amen. Now eat Jesus. Eat Jesus. The host. Okay, very good. Let us pray. By our receiving of the body and blood of your only begotten Son, Jesus, at this heavenly table, grant that on this feast day of Saint Anthony of Padua, that we may be strengthened to continue our journey here on earth to your heavenly kingdom. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Boys and girls, you received Holy Communion in such a very reverent way, and we ask God's blessing upon you and your parents in a very, very special way also, okay? So, and I want to thank all your instructors and your family for preparing you so well for your first Holy Communion. Huh? What do we think, moms and dads? And we also are very happy this week because the Pope has sent us a new bishop, and he will be coming to us in August, okay? And his name is David Toops, and he's only 49 years of age, so he's very young, and he's very, very vibrant, okay? So it's a wonderful, wonderful time for us to rejoice, even though we have the virus going on, and a lot of unrest in many of our cities. And I'll just leave this with you because it's part of my homily for the weekend. Holy Communion is the reception of Jesus and the entire Trinity, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. God, who's made us, has made every single one of us special. We are all special. And we are called to respect one another, be in a holy communion with one another, and help and take care of one another. So that's very, very important, okay? Because if we say we have a holy communion with God, and we don't have a holy communion with all the people who share this planet with us, this earth, ooh, that doesn't make sense. If we love God, we've got to love everybody. Okay? The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And through the prayers of the Holy Mother of God, together with all the saints, especially our special Saint Anthony, may the Lord bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.